Ah, Mr. Secretary.
Mr. Burr, sir.
Did you hear the news about good old General Mercer?
No.
You know Claremont Street?
Yeah.
They renamed it after him. The Mercer legacy is secure.
Sure.
And all he had to do was die.
Yeah, that's a lot less work.
We ought to give it a try. Now how you gonna get your debt plan through?
I guess I'm gonna finally have to listen to you.
Really?
Talk less. Smile more. Do whatever it takes to get my plan on the Congress floor.
Now Madison and Jefferson are merciless.
Well, hate the sin, love the sinner.
Hamilton.
I'm sorry, Burr, I gotta go.
But
decisions are happening over dinner.
Two Virginians and an immigrant walk into a room.
Diametrically opposed foes.
They emerge with a compromise, having opened doors that were
previously closed. Bros.
The immigrant emerges with unprecedented financial power, a system he can shape however he wants. The Virginians emerge with the nation's capital. And here's the pièce de résistance. No one else was in the room where it happened, the room where it happened, the room where it happened. No one else was in the room where it happened, the room where it happened, the room where it happened. No one really knows how the game is played, the art of the trade, how the sausage gets made. We just assume that it happens, but no one else is in the room where it happens.
Alexander was on Washington's doorstep one day in distress and disarray.
Thomas Claims.
Alexander said,
I've nowhere else to turn.
And basically begged me to join the fray.
Thomas Claims.
I approached Madison and said, I know you hate him, but let's hear what he has to say.
Thomas Claims.
Well, I arranged the meeting. I arranged the menu, the venue, the seating.
But no one else was in the room where it happened. The room where it happened. The room where it happened. No one else was in the room where it happened. The room where it happened. The room where it happened. No one really knows how the parties get to yes. The pieces that are sacrificed in every game of chess. We just assume that it happens, but no one else is in the room where it happens. Meanwhile, Madison is grappling with the fact that not every issue can be settled by committee.
Meanwhile,
Congress is fighting over where to put the capital. It isn't pretty. Then Jefferson approaches with a dinner and invite, and Madison responds with Virginian insight.
Maybe we can solve one problem with another and win a victory for the Southerners. In other words,
oh, ho.
A quid pro quo.
I suppose.
Wouldn't you like to work a little closer to home?
Actually, I would.
Well, I propose the Potomac.
And you'll provide him his votes.
Well, we'll see how it goes.
Let's go.
No.
What else was in the room where it happened? The room where it happened. The room where it happened.
No one else is in the room where it happened.
Alexander Hamilton.
What did they say to you to get you to sell New York City down the river?
Alexander Hamilton.
Did Washington know about the dinner? Was there presidential pressure to deliver?
Alexander Hamilton.
Or did you know even then it doesn't matter where you put the U.S. Capitol?
Cause we'll have the banks, we're in the same spot.
You got more than you gave.
And I wanted what I got. When you got skin in the game, you stay in the game. But you don't get a win unless you play in the game. Oh, you get love for it, you get hate for it, you get nothing if you
wait for it, wait for it, wait.
God help and forgive me, I wanna build something that's gonna outlive me.
What do you want, girl? What do you want, girl? You stand for nothing, girl. What do you fall for?
I wanna be in the room where it happens, the room where it happens. I wanna be in the room where it happens, the room where it happens.
I wanna be in the room where it happens.
I wanna be in the room where it happens. Saying what they trade away.
We dream of a brand new start.
But we dream in the dark for the most part.
Dark as a tomb where it happens. I've got to be in the room. I've got to be
where it happens.
sister writes me a letter every day. I'm keeping her bed warm while her husband is away. He's on the British side in Georgia. He's trying to keep the colonies in line, but he can keep all of Georgia. Theodosia, she's mine. Love doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes and it takes and it takes, and we keep loving anyway. We laugh and we cry and we break and we make our mistakes. And if there's a reason, I'm by her side. So many have tried, then I'm willing to wait for it. I'm willing to wait for it.
Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it.
My grandfather was a fire and brimstone preacher.
Preacher. Preacher. Preacher.
But there are things that the homilies and hymns won't teach ya.
Teacher.
My mother was a genius. My father commanded respect.
Respect.
When they died, they left no instructions, just a legacy to protect. Death doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes and it takes and it takes, and we keep living anyway. We rise and we fall and we break and we make our mistakes. And if there's a reason, I'm still alive when everyone who loves me has died. I'm willing to wait for it.
Wait for it.
I'm willing to wait for it. Standing still, lying, lying in
wait.
Hamilton faces an endless uphill
climb.
He has something to prove, he got nothing to lose. Hamilton faces relentless, he wastes no time. What is it like in his shoes? Hamilton doesn't hesitate, he exhibits no restraint. Takes and he takes and he takes, and he keeps winning anyway. Changes the game, plays and he raises the stakes. And if there's a reason, he seems to thrive, and so few survive. Then goddammit, I'm willing to wait for it.